Welcome to Conversessions, a program that attempts to bring the artist experience closer to you and you closer to the artist. I'm Will Sterling, and today we're in conversation and performance with Boris Smile.
My man Wesley Chung, captain of Boris Smile.
Baby, why can't you see? Love's gotta come from the heart. Baby, why can't you see? Love's gotta come from the heart.
Has Boris Smile ever played a junior high before?
No, but we've played like 16-year-old birthday parties. And we've played
high school youth groups.
We've played house shows, and we would wait until the audience, the number of people in the audience equaled or was greater to the amount of members in the band. So we wouldn't play until 9 people showed up.
You feel like they were like vibing.
It felt like for the first time you're playing music and people get it. You know, you're like there's no walls in front of them. There's nothing. There's no V-necks and a cigarette in their hand, going like, oh, geez, I heard Pitchfork said blah blah blah. You know, like they're these young people with you know horizontal striped shirts, just running around being crazy and just going, oh, you know, I just love the music. And they did a Ring Around the Rosie, like actually did it. Like it was just this celebration of life and youth, and it was just a beautiful thing.
Today we're in conversation with the captain of Boris Smile, Mr. Wesley Chung, and bassist Doug Brown. Welcome, guys.
Thanks.
How you doing? We're glad to have you. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Boris Smile? I think specifically for me, why don't you tell us a little bit about the name? I'm just very intrigued by the name of the band. Where did that start?
Yeah. Well, my neighbor, it was probably 8 or 7 at the time. His name is Boris. It was a Russian family next door.
Okay.
So every time I'd go to my garage to record anything, he'd always be sitting on the wall. I was just hanging out. So he's always a smiley kid. So
gotcha.
I think I wrote it down on a post-it note. I said Boris Smile.
Which
came into my head. So I said, that's the name.
Very nice. So. Now how about the you know, you call yourself the captain of Boris Smile. So where did that come about? Is that...
No, I think someone else coined that phrase, said, oh, Wesley's the captain. I think just because it goes back and forth between, at times, has been more of a band, like
okay.
a stronger kind of creative group. And then other times it's been me being kind of leading things a bit more creatively.
Right.
And everyone else being more of a collective.
And you
yeah.
reached out to friends, you reached out to...
Yeah. Because I started just in a high school band that would just play birthday parties and stuff. And then as that started slowing down, I started recording stuff on my own. And then we were going to play something, someone's event. So I just grabbed some people. I grabbed my brother and then some other friends I had. And from there, yeah, it's been 7 years. And
wow.
just been adding different members and different friends and or people I've never met yet.
Okay.
That just said, oh, I'd love... Yeah, our trumpet player, Meagan, we saw her at a concert. She had heard of the band and said, oh, yeah, I'd love to play trumpet on some of your stuff. And that was like 4 years ago or 5 years ago. So.
Wow, and she's still with the group then?
Yeah, yeah, and there's members that come in and out, and there's some that are more core that are able to be there. But so it's kind of loose band, but
okay.
also collective. But so it's kind of, it's this thing.
It's always an ever-changing thing, I guess.
Yeah, to some degree, yeah.
And so, Doug, then what? When did you come on to the band?
Back in 2007, I actually met Wesley in a college class, which was really interesting because he kind of had like a TA position where he helped with like facilitating the class, and I had just left. I was in a hardcore punk band at the time, which just completely, like every great punk band, destroyed itself. And I met Wesley, and I had just been telling him about, like, yeah, I just really miss playing music, and he's like, well, we, do you want to jam sometime? I had heard about Boris Smile actually when I was in high school. From like my really close friend who just said, you should check out this band.
And you had a reputation.
He did, and you know, and it's so strange because this guy, you know, the guy who had introduced me to him had no connection to Wesley whatsoever the first time I'd heard him. So coming full circle to sitting next to him, and he was just saying, I have a band called Boris Smile. I just went, a small world, you know. So, but from that first jam, you know.
7 years, you said, you guys have been together.
Yeah.
And you've been with the band, you said?
4 years.
4 years, yeah. Okay. Then there's a song of yours called Heart of Gold. Mm-hmm. That's something that you wrote personally. Mm-hmm. Is that something that's very personal to you? I know there's a music video to go with it. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, Heart of Gold, that's on our newest album called My Love, Powered by 10,000 Practice Amps.
Okay.
It's 23 tracks. 23 tracks of... Of songs.
Okay.
And so that one was inspired by a friend of mine. I went to England for 8 months.
Okay.
And lived on like a manor house.
Okay.
And it was like a communal living study center. Uh-huh. And for like 3 of those months I just did laundry for 40 people every day and for my food and stay. And so a lot of the songs coming after that were, for the new record, were just songs for friends, like the idea of a song being a gift for someone.
Right, right.
So that song is just inspired by a friend that I met out there.
Okay. Well, let's take a look. Yeah. I think we've got it if we want to pull it up.
Great. Shades of green, death of death, things unseen, pen with ink, pages wide, faithful test by fireside. And am I alone in the mysterious unknown, with the seeds of doubt planted in my mind? Make me a heart of gold, make me white as snow. The shadows and their countrymen gladly take me by the hand. They'll tell me where to go through the darkest of my soul.
Great, very nice. So that was, you said there's 23 tracks then on the new album. Do they all vary in length, or they all kind of have a standard? Because I mean, the song. I think what's nice about the song is that it says what it needs to say, and then it, you know what I mean, you guys.
Yeah, they're really short.
Right. Okay.
A lot of them. It's almost like an idea. That was the nice thing about it. I think coming back from my time in England and just having, I think. The title is kind of how I felt. I felt really full of love for these people that I met, and feeling like gifted by or blessed by meeting these people. So it felt like this album is like plugging a bunch of, you know, practice amps into my heart and just going blah. So
very cool. So that's kind of the origin of the title.
Yeah. So a lot of just little songs as gifts.
Gotcha.
In a way that.
Cool. And instrumentally, you play bass, but it seems like, at least from your guys' thing, some people might be involved in other things. Do you play any other instruments or involved in anything else?
Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely kind of I try to play as much as I possibly can, just because, yeah, I definitely love playing music, and now that I've graduated, I'm interested in pursuing more of that. But yeah, live, I mean, I use different like mini synthesizers and various percussive things just to kind of round out the music, because I think we're definitely, you know, interested in experimenting with sound, because especially with pop music, you can only do, you know, a certain thing so many times before you start to realize and make connections like, oh, the Beatles did all that, or you know, like, especially now the Beach Boys, you know, I mean, you can really, you know, point fingers at those things, which is not a bad thing at all,
right.
But yeah, so I think we sonically try to experiment with things as much as possible. So.
In terms of the way that you guys play, what's the basic structure for you? Do you guys just get together and jam and you kind of figure things out, or do you sort of have a structure that you go through to kind of, you know, build your songs?
I think we, one of the things is, like, Wesley's definitely our core songwriter.
Okay.
I mean, it is his, you know, baby, to kind of put it that way. And most of the time what happens is we end up getting in together after he's shown us the songs, and so we'll kind of layer it. So it kind of always has its foundation, and then it becomes something else entirely by the end of it. But I think the coolest part about working with Wesley is he's completely open to, you know, not only, like, moving things around, but if things, you know, if at first, you know, something feels a little strange, you know, kind of saying, like, well, what if we went this way with the song, and he's not, you know, opposed to that.
Right.
You know.
So do you primarily start with lyrics first? You kind of... You write something out and then add music to it later. Do you
actually just the opposite? Always music.
Oh really? We've got another song ready. Cheaters Never Prosper. Is there anything that you guys want to intro that with before people take a look? Is there some specific stuff behind it or a meaning to that title or anything?
That one's just yeah, it's funny. That was off our first record.
Okay.
And that song just, I think, is. So some of the songs off the first record, I think I began to write in high school.
Gotcha.
So that one's, just fed up about cheating in school.
Okay.
And the music video was never fully finished, but once again, us trying something new. Yeah, we've never done anything rotoscope, so.
Okay.
It was an unfinished attempt, but I still really like it.
Awesome. Well, let's take a look at it then. We are in conversation with Boris Smile. We're here with Wesley Chung, the captain of Boris Smile, as well as Doug Brown, the bassist, as well as other instruments. That was Cheaters Never Prosper. Yeah, one thing I noticed too is that you guys are definitely not afraid to go back into personal things, you know, from your past or things that affected you, you know, like cheating and all those things, like when, you know, you were in high school. And the next thing that we have ready is A Cruel Time in Life. So what is that a specific thing that happened to you or something that you really connect with where you wrote a song based on? On an experience?
Middle school, yeah.
Okay.
It's the cruelest time in life.
Middle school is the cruelest time in life.
Yeah, well, that's how I felt.
Okay.
So,
not a good middle school experience.
Yeah, well, you just feel like, I felt kind of invisible in middle school, so it's just funny to write about that. I spent 4 years working with middle school.
Right.
Like through a youth group.
So okay.
Just kind of almost reliving it with a different spin on things, and I did an American studies major, so it's just understanding American culture. So
okay.
Through it all, this album called Young and It Feels So Good came out of that. And
okay.
The song Cruel Time in Life is just about just the awkwardness and almost kind of just a song to be like, it gets better. Right. Just saying.
Cool. I know that's a big. I mean, that's a big thing now is it gets better. So, well, let's take a look at A Cruel Time in Life.
Junior high, oh junior high, leave me alone, I want to die, oh, cause my parents in acne won't leave me alone. Junior high, oh junior high, give back my lunch, I wanna cry, oh, cause these bullies are getting bolder every year. The metal in your teeth makes it hard for you to pray that your parents will medicate you with the pills that help you focus in the day. Oh, junior high, oh, junior high, disappear and hide, don't be yourself, it's social suicide. Come on, my child, don't believe the lies. Since these girls have been letting down their ponytails. Junior high, oh junior high, alas I must say goodbye, oh, to my angelic voice for a voice that's broken and cracked. Our bodies are growing and our hormones are going insane. My children's men and I'm left to be the boy the silver man remains. Junior high, oh junior high, disappear and hide, don't be yourself, social suicide.
This is Conversessions, and we are in studio with the captain of Boris Smile, Wesley Chung, and bassist Doug Brown. So you said you had some experience working with middle schoolers there for Cruel Time in Life. What did working with the middle schoolers then, were you kind of devoted to making sure their time in life maybe not as cruel as what you remembered in middle school?
Yeah, definitely. I think just being able to, kind of understand where they're coming from. I think at times when it's just ingrained in your brain, you're like, oh, yeah, that's awful.
Right.
And you guys, like, they're just getting braces.
Right.
And,
some of the lyrics are very specific to
stuff
I even remember about junior high and sweaty palms and all that stuff.
Yeah, when you don't get invited to just, like, one bar mitzvah, like, it's really messed up.
So. Right. So in terms of that music video, did you guys play at a middle school? Was that filmed at a middle school?
Yeah, it was an elementary and middle school. They had this dance, and our drummer at the time was the PE coach.
Okay.
His nickname in the band was Coachy.
Okay.
They called him Coachy.
Very cool.
it's not actually.
It's not cool. You hated
really
the
lame,
nickname.
No, just really lame nickname. We loved it though.
Another thing that's cool about that video too is that you guys, at one point, it's like everybody's out on the stage and you guys are, everybody's like so involved and it's very physical and it's like everybody's playing something and the drummer's going from drums to playing on the tambourine and it's like, is that something that you guys just love to embrace, just everybody getting active and...
Oh yeah, definitely. I think that, you know, and still even looking back on that, like as much as I've, like maybe we've had shows that are really exciting or like great opportunities, for me, that was like sentimentally probably like one of the greatest moments that I've had, like in sharing music with people, just because, yeah, again, like even beyond like the pretensions and things, it's just amazing to see people, you know, just to be reminded why, you know, you make music and why you're doing what you do, because just seeing people, you know, just kind of dancing as wild as humanly possible, not trying to look like they're in a rap music video, which is, you know, it's an incredible thing. And you just, you know, for those brief few seconds, because being a musician is definitely not a super glorious thing. You know, you get pretty much no money unless you know, make that really great hit, or, you know, and I think that it's moments like that that remind you, this is why I do this, you know.
Right. Well, you got your guitar with you. Is there a song that you want to play for us and for our audience? You know, a live performance, a song that's close to your heart.
Yeah, we're gonna play a song off the new record.
Okay.
My Love, powered by 10,000 practice amps. This song is called "A Cake to Make Friends With."
A cake to make friends with. Uh-huh. Okay.
And Doug will help me sing, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'd like it.
Okay.
Would you do that for me?
That's
brother.
Yeah.
And this one also just inspired by my friend Lauda, who I met in England.
Okay.
So, at this manor house I was living at, it was international and had people from all over, and she was from the Netherlands, and we were having a good time. She started becoming friends with everyone, and then she said, "Oh, my cake," and this was at dinner, and she just runs up to her room, comes back with this cake, and we're like, "What are you doing? What is that exactly?" And she goes, "A cake to make friends with. My mother said, bring it. My mother said, bring a cake. When you make friends, break bread with them." And so, like,
that's awesome.
Share it with friends. So, this is about inspired by her and a lot of other things. So. Separated by these chairs and tables, bring your righteous gifts. If you were Cain, then I guess I am Abel. I'm the mouse who gets his crumbs for free. Oh, bread of life, won't you fill up me? Bread alone is not the way to live, and I got nothing but myself to give. At least it's something.
cake for friends. Bread from heaven, not made by hand.
It's fantastic. So that was another inspiration of your travels and times in England.
Yeah.
And so you said that this with this new album, then a lot of the songs that are on there, if not the majority, were inspired by the time that you spent over there.
Yeah, and just definitely the people, and just maybe conversations I had with them during my time there. And I want to keep using
It's beautiful. You use a great word.
Yeah.
All right, guys, well, the next song that we have queued up is Queen of Green Welly. You want to tell us a little bit about the meaning of the name, the inspiration for the song?
Yes, I do. Queen of Green Welly, like a lot of the record, it is dedicated to a very special lady in okay. real life in Scotland. Shout out. Glasgow town. Helen Kellick. I've been dating her for 2 years, and so this song's about her. It's her one of her favorite restaurants is the Green Welly Stop, and in the UK, a welly is a boot. So there's it's a restaurant with a big smiling green boot on the front, just a cafeteria, and they sell tea cozies.
Very cool.
So that song's dedicated to her, and the music video you're gonna see is was all filmed at a place called Swamp Southwest Arts and Music Project. Right there in Pollock. Shout out Pollock. It's not a live audience, so no one's shouting out. But and we're
it's
in America.
Good, I think.
But if they see it, they'll like it.
Of course.
And
so all that information, then they can find on your Facebook page or your Twitter account or
Facebook. A place for friends.
That's
yeah,
right.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. So the Facebook Boris Smile.
Okay.
You can also buy all of our records at Count Your Lucky Stars Records. And
shout out
Keith. From
Count Your Lucky Stars. Count
Your
Lucky Stars, right? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
It's all available on iTunes as well. And then
anywhere you can buy music online.
Okay. So. And the new album is called?
My Love, Powered by 10,000 Practice Amps.
Great. Fantastic. Well, we want to thank you guys for sitting with us in conversation today.
Thank you.
This has been Boris Smile. This is Captain Boris Smile, Mr. Wesley Chung, and bassist Doug Brown. So we want to thank you guys for joining us. I'm Will Sterling, and I guess we'll see you next time on Conversessions.
See you.